Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, we're going to do negligent discharge stories 14. Now, as you guys may know, if you have followed me for any length of period of time, I've been doing these ND stories for quite some time. 1 through, we'll say, 12. And that, I think the 12th one was in 2016, and I kind of stopped doing them for about 3 years, all right? I just did the Benelli, which was number 13, so this is number 14. There was a reason why I stopped doing them in 2016, and that's a lot of drama behind the scenes. I had reenacted some stories that were either false or fake, or some guy said, well, wait a minute, I didn't want you to do that, and now I'm mad and pissed, I'm going to report you. What? And another one was an actual story of somebody else who contacted me and said, how did you know about that situation? Who told you that? I never said anyone that could, you know, talk about that. And because it's an active investigation, apparently, now what the hell, you know? So I had this, like, weirdness. So I just was like, you know what? I'm going to stop doing these ND stories just because. I'll do them if I know the person well. But I kind of just stopped. I do get a lot of emails still of these stories of people saying they get into gunfights and their ND stories. And it, I don't know. Some of it's too fantastic. Meaning it's like literally a story out of a movie, possibly. I don't know. I just don't want to get involved with reenacting stuff that I kind of think is not real, you know? But anyways, let's get on with this. This is a very simple situation. Again, this happened to somebody that owns a Springfield Scout, which has an 18-inch barrel. Now, this one here is the SOCOM 16. Very, very cool rifle. I love it a lot. Very powerful in a small package. Look at this thing. So this is what I have, but he had a Scout and he had an ND at the range, and this is what basically happened. So I'll explain to you and reenact it, but let's make safe right here. All right, let's just take this magazine out of here and I'll keep it away for now. There's no ammunition around. All right, so we look in the chamber, nothing going on in there. All right, so let's just say he's at the rifle range, right? And he just loaded up his Springfield Scout. Just like that, he's got his magazine in there. He's around in the chamber. He now needs to put the rifle on safe. So in order to put the safety on these M1As, or you guys probably know all about this, it's in an unorthodox position. It's a little weird and different. But for me personally, when I have to put this rifle on safe, all right, we just say we put it around in the chamber, I will take the trigger finger, put it underneath the trigger guard, and then move it on the outside until I hit that hard spot right there. So I would go like this, hit that hard spot, okay, and I'll feel that. I'll try to do a visual inspection, okay, push it towards me. We're on safe. That's on safe. So to take it off safe, right, take it off safe, I do the same thing by going like this. Keep your finger out of the trigger guard, and I just follow it all the way around. It's smooth, right, whoop. And then I put my thumb in there like that and push forward. Safety is off, ready to go, ready to fire. Safety on. Oh, I feel that touch there. I'll do a visual. Okay, push forward, kind of like that. Kind of like that. And then to take the safety off, go straight up. Thumb goes in to the trigger guard. I feel it. Feel it. Push it forward, and I'm ready to fire. Boom. So what he did was basically racks around in there. And for him, and this is very quick, he wanted to put the safety on. He wasn't doing a visual inspection, right? Wasn't doing any visual inspection, and he goes like this, boom, and fires the rifle unintentionally into the dirt right in front of him, scaring himself that he drops the rifle on the ground, and he's just kind of like, whoa, and people around him were also scared, like, what did you just do? Like, they didn't know what happened, because he dropped the rifle and ran away from it. Yeah, so, as you saw, you got to know your platforms, right? So turn that safety on, he just went like this into here, thinking he was here. So I can see how that happens. He's here, but he thinks he's here. Push the safety back. Wait a minute, that's not the safety. Boom. Fires a 7.62 by 51, or 308, unintentionally, off guard, not knowing what's going on, and freaks him out completely. And he scares everybody else on the rifle range at the same time. So he learned his lesson to be more... You have to have that discipline. Just look. Maybe that's what you should do. Just look. So if you just look, I see it's right here. Safety is on. Okay? I take the safety off, I just look, all right, push it with the thumb, safety's off, I'm ready to go. Safety on, all right, I'll just look. But for me, like I said, when I need to put the safety on, I just follow that over. Okay, there it is, safety on. Okay, put the safety off, there we go. Look, okay, I see it here. Okay, so again, for him, he thought he had his finger on the safety here, and he thought he was pushing it back, but he fired his rifle unintentionally, and that's still a negligent discharge. So just know your platform, whatever you got. I know this rifle here may not be the most popular amongst people that are using it for defensive purposes or what have you, but they're out there. A lot of people do have these, and they love them, and they will use them for home defense. You know, maybe 308 might be a bit much for indoors, but some people, this is all they got. If this is all you got, or an M1 Garand, or just an M1A, or a Scout, like you got the Scout, then just understand the system, the safety, and all that stuff. How to, you know, it just goes back to know your tools. Know your tools of the trade, basically. Like if you carry a 1911, understand if there's a thumb safety there, you know, just things like that. But this, I can see how that could happen, and I wonder if it happens more than we think, or people are thinking they're pushing the safety, but they're pulling the trigger, pressing that trigger back instead of pushing this back. It's not like, here, hold on a second. So right here I have a AR-15 platform. This is actually a pistol, this is not a rifle, but it looks like an AR-15, right? No. Anyways, more people are gonna be familiar with a safety mechanism like what's on this type of firearm here, right? You got the safety right there. So let's just make safe with this one, right? Actually, let's just get rid of the magazine here. Put it to the side. Okay. So, just wanted to kind of share that ND situation with you, all right? This is the pistol, so share that ND situation with you. Hold on, let me grab this one more time. As you can see, the safety's over here, right? Over here. So in order to disengage or engage, you're just really close to the whole firing mechanism, the trigger. So you just have to be aware of that and learn it, practice, train safely, of course, so you don't have a negligent discharge at the range or geez, in your house because you're not looking and you think you got you're pressing the safety back, but you're actually pressing the trigger back. So guys, that was just a quick negligent discharge story 14. And you leave some comments below, let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.